I just want to say that if you don't believe in the power of tarot cards or fortune telling, then that's fair. Because honestly, I don't either. But even if fortune telling isn't your thing, chances are that you still have an understanding of tarot cards due to their strong media presence. From video games to television and even film, tarot cards have been employed as symbols of mystery and the occult. After all, nothing quite screams magic and mystery like elaborately decorated pieces of cardboard. But while the cards themselves are familiar, the convoluted and strange history surrounding them is less well known. So I submit for the approval of the Midnight Society, the history of the tarot. The origin of tarot cards can be traced to Italy during the early 15th century, where they were used to play a game very similar to modern bridge. Unlike modern playing cards, however, these cards were divided into five suits, the fifth of which being an elaborately decorated group of face cards referred to as the triomphi, or trumps in English. While it is uncertain who invented this game, the prevailing theory is that it was created by members of the Italian aristocracy, and eventually found its way into public circles. While early decks are hard to come by, thanks to a sermon delivered by Franciscan Friar during the later half of the 15th century, we have a fairly clear picture of what a traditional deck would have looked like. According to the Friar, while the number of trumps could vary, a typical deck contained 21 face cards, many of which were remarkably similar to modern versions. The sermon also seems to suggest that the main purpose of these cards was gameplay rather than divination, as the Friar describes them as a game, albeit one created by the devil. Despite the Friar's clear objections, the popularity of trumps soon spread outside of Italy to France, where, in the early 16th century, the city of Marseille became a center of production for the popular playing cards. As their popularity increased, the decks became more standardized, to the point that by the 17th century, all decks contained 22 numbered trump cards, each with a set iconography. These changes eventually culminated in the creation of the Marseille deck, the historical precursor to all modern tarot. It was also during the early 16th century that the words tarocco and tarocchi first surfaced in Italy, both terms used to refer to decks of cards that contain trumps. While both words have been cited as the precursor to the French term tarot, the etymology of both has been lost to time, so we have no idea where the terms came from or what they originally meant. Mysterious. If you're thinking that this video has been pretty tame considering the subject matter, then you're right, as things didn't really get interesting until 1781, when French occultist Antoine Court de Gobelin published the first occult interpretation of the tarot. According to de Gobelin, what most people perceived as common playing cards were really segments of an ancient Egyptian book of knowledge, created by sages, possibly those under the direction of the famous sage Hermes Trismegistus, which were then smuggled into Europe by gypsies. If you're wondering how de Gobelin came to such a creative conclusion, he honestly just made everything up. The only evidence de Gobelin had for his theory was his belief that the images used to decorate the Marseille deck contained hidden hermetic and astrological symbols. But as I just went over the history of the first tarot cards, it's clear that de Gobelin's theory did not have a historical leg to stand on. His theory regarding how the ancient book of knowledge was transported to Europe is also incorrect, as gypsies are a group of traditionally itinerant people that migrated to Europe from South Asia, not Egypt. Though de Gobelin's confusion is understandable, as in order to gain favor with the European courts, many gypsies at this time claimed to be exiled Christians from Egypt. Though lacking in historical evidence, de Gobelin's theory sparked occult interest in the tarot that lasted for over a century, and generated multiple theories regarding their power and symbolism. One such theorist was Jean-Baptiste Elliott, who theorized that the tarot actually derived from a legendary book of wisdom written by the Egyptian god Thoth, aka the Book of Thoth. Based on this theory, in 1789, Elliott created one of the first sets of tarot cards designed specifically for the purpose of divination. Elliott's tarot, later referred to as the Egyptian tarot, shared many features in common with the Marseille deck, but integrated elements of Egyptian mythology and symbolism into its design. While the Egyptian tarot never eclipsed the Marseille deck in popularity, Elliot's theories, along with those of his predecessor, Antoine Corte de Gobelin, were carried forward into the 19th century, where they helped inspire new occult practices and organizations. One such organization was the Hermetic Order of the Golden Dawn, a group founded in 1888 by Dr. Wynne Westcott and his friend MacGregor Mathers. The story of this particular occult organization is interesting, to say the least. Apparently, one day in 1887, Dr. Westcott was given a mysterious document that a friend of his discovered on a shelf in a secondhand bookstore. The document, later referred to as the Cipher MS, was written in 16th century code and talked about a secret society called the Hermetic Order of the Golden Dawn. Because secret society members always take confidential documents when they go shopping for books, right? Anyway, Westcott decided that creating a secret occult society sounded like fun, so he contacted the leader of the German branch of the order, a woman by the name of Frau Springle. Wait, wasn't this supposed to be a secret society? And asked for permission to create a UK division of the order. And if this story sounds a bit far-fetched, that's because it is. There's no evidence that a German division of the Order of the Golden Dawn ever existed. And it is completely possible that Westcott just made everything up, because what's an occult society without a convoluted and slightly implausible backstory? If you're wondering what any of this has to do with tarot cards, then don't worry, I'm getting there. The Cipher MS, in addition to exposing the secrets of a non-existent occult society, also contained a few pages about the tarot. In addition to referencing the history and symbolism of the tarot, the Cipher MS also introduced multiple stylistic changes to its design. These included changing the card suits from their traditional Italian titles of staffs, swords, coins, and cups, to the more mystical wands, swords, pentacles, and cups. Each of the suits was then paired with one of the four elements: wands with fire, swords with air, cups with water, and pentacles with earth. The 22 trump cards were each assigned a letter from the Hebrew alphabet, as well as either a planet or astrological symbol, because why not? Well, the connection between the tarot trumps and the Hebrew alphabet was first established by de Gobelin, the other alterations may have been for the purpose of incorporating more mysticism into the tarot. Though, don't quote me on that. The Hermetic Order of the Golden Dawn was initially quite popular, bringing together scholars and researchers from across the country, including Arthur Edward Waite and Pamela Smith, the creators of the aptly named Waite-Smith Tarot. Published in 1910, the Waite-Smith Tarot was the first deck to feature illustrated versions of the 56 suit or pip cards, a common feature in most modern tarot decks. As the primary designer, Smith combined detailed and creative artwork with historical influences like the Marseille Tarot deck to create a truly unforgettable design, while Arthur Waite's book, The Key of the Tarot, which was published the same year, helped to bolster the deck's popularity. While the tarot's prominence in pop culture has helped to ensure that there is no end to the number and design of available decks on the market, the Waite-Smith deck still persists as the most popular and influential version of the tarot in modern memory, with over 100 million copies currently in circulation across the globe. So that was the very convoluted history of tarot cards, everyone's favorite occult playing card game. If you like this video, then please like and subscribe, as this will help keep you informed every time I upload a new video. Well, I'm Silver Jade, saying please remember to support your local library, and I'll see you next time.